If you saw this image along with every other human on the face of the Earth, you probably still would not be killed by it. Let's talk about how you're probably wrong about SCP-096. SCP-096 is a terrifying concept. If you see an image of its face, it will try to kill you. It will run to where you are, and it will kill you. You will just disappear, actually, off the face of the Earth. What it does is not exactly certain, but it takes a couple seconds to do it, and then it moves on to the next person, or it goes back into a docile state. So imagine for a second that there's some malevolent entity and or organization out there that's decided it wants to help destroy the world. So it shows a picture of SCP-096 on every digital device, on every television, everywhere in the world at the exact same time. What happens? Not as much as you think. So let's run some numbers real quick. First of all, let's talk about how close you are on average to another human being. The average density of humans on Earth is about 14.7 persons per square kilometer. Now, a lot of that is also going to be ocean. If you talk about just the Earth's landmass, that number goes up. If you talk about just Earth's livable space, that number goes up. So, you know, not deserts, not giant Arctic wastelands. But in the end, we're talking about an entity that's still going to have to traverse those deserts and or oceans and or Arctic wastelands. So we can probably just talk about the Earth as a whole. The Earth is, it's large. There's no other way to put it. The Earth is very, very large. It's about 510 million square kilometers. In one of the documents about SCP-096, it takes almost an hour for it to eventually find an individual. So it takes time to travel. This is a guarantee. And the idea that it gets faster depending on how far away things are is still true, but I think it's not a matter of it has, you know, it's not one of those things where it's the same amount of time to get to each person. If it's something is sufficiently far away, there is a top speed that it just has to get to and then wait until it gets to where it needs to go. Now, all of this information should be taken into account, but I'm not going to actually have to bother because I looked at the numbers absent that. Imagine for a second it takes 2 seconds for SCP-096 to kill someone. That's 1 second for travel and 1 second for murdering, and then 1 second for travel to the next person. Now, what we don't understand for sure about SCP-096 is how it selects its victims. Well, other than that they've seen its face, but if multiple people have seen its face, how does it select its next victim after killing someone? Is it random? Is it proximity-based? In this case, again, it shouldn't matter. We're going to assume that in this scenario, everybody worldwide was showed the picture at the exact same time. Now, this doesn't really matter from a basic perspective, but we're just doing it because it makes the numbers a little smoother. There will be some variance to this, but there won't be a huge amount of variance based on how, you know, like if one region catches the image first and then another region catches the image after, there will be some variance, but it won't be so significant as to change things. So we're just going to estimate that it takes 2 seconds to kill each individual person, which is way low. The answer to that is probably much, much higher, especially considering, like I said, it took him at least an hour to get to the middle of the Pacific Ocean. I think it was the Pacific Ocean. Regardless, it took him an hour to get out into the ocean once, so travel distances are going to vary significantly. But let's pretend for a second that the average is just 1 second. 1 second to get to the next person, and 1 second to get to the next person. If you look at the numbers, there are about 7.5 billion people in the world. By now, you should probably begin to understand where this is going. Let's assume 7.5 billion people do not see the image of SCP-096. Now, I know that we started from the outset and said everyone's going to see it, but in our scenario, we're assuming digital whatevers, and not everyone in the world has a phone. There are more phones in the world than there are people, but not everyone owns one. In a lot of super rural areas, maybe people do not see this image of SCP-096. So we're going to take 0.5 billion people off the top and say they will not be affected by this problem. If it takes 2 seconds to kill each person, that's 14 billion seconds. Now we're going to do a little bit of math real quick, and you're going to be probably a little disappointed by what you find. Let's see, 14 billion, there we go, divided by 60 seconds. It will take 233,333,333.3333 minutes. We're going to divide that by 60 again. It will take 3,888,888.88888 hours. And we'll divide that again by 24 for days. It's going to take 162,037 days. And finally, we're going to divide that by 365. In order to kill every human being on the face of the Earth who has seen its image, with only 2 seconds per person, it would take 443 years. Most of those people will, of course, die from natural causes in the meantime. Here's the important thing to understand about this. What we're doing is essentially adding 0.5 deaths per second to the... because it's 2 seconds to kill a person. So 0.5 people per second are killed by SCP-096. The total death rate per second on Earth right now is 1.8. So we're only kicking it up from 1.8 to 2.3, which is roughly like what? An increase of somewhere around... I'm just doing this in my head. And I have no idea exactly for the numbers, but it's an increase of something close to 25%. Somewhere between 20 and 25, I think. Either way, to be fair, I will say this. The number one cause of death worldwide would become SCP-096. That number would be such a drastic increase on the total death toll per second that, yes, most people in the world would be killed. Most people in the world would be killed by something other than SCP-096, but the highest, the biggest killer in the world would be SCP-096. Heart disease would be actually very close behind. Cardiovascular disease would be incredibly close behind SCP-096. SCP-096 would still be the biggest killer in the world, but cardiovascular disease might catch up eventually. I think cardiovascular disease is something like 21% of all deaths. So anything over 2 seconds and the leading cause of death in the world will no longer be this anomaly. It will be something else. Invariably, it'll be cardiovascular disease. Give it a few more seconds and it'll be, and things like cancer or violence might actually outstrip it. But this means that there's a strong possibility that somebody who was born and was showed the image the day they were born could live to the age of 70 and never once see SCP-096, which, you know, when you think about it, makes no sense, but is absolutely 100% true. And it would be the kind of thing that would just be baked into everyday human interactions. I'll tell you this, airplanes would probably fly with less people on them, just in general, because, like, the really big issue with SCP-096 is that it's willing to break through anything to get to the person it wants to kill, which can end up killing other people. But people die, in charge of, bus drivers die instantaneously, a heart attack that kills them like that, and they crash, and not everyone on board dies. That's not how that works. Airplanes are a little different. If SCP-096 tears through the fuselage of an airplane, there's a good chance that a lot of the people on that plane could die. There's also a good chance that they might not. Like, it depends on the plane, it depends on how high they are, there's a whole bunch of factors involved in that. But in general, you would expect that high-risk things like airplane flight would involve less people. Instead of packing 400 people onto an airplane, you might pack 20 or 30. So life would still change worldwide to mitigate the chances of you dying to somebody else dying of SCP-096. But you wouldn't necessarily... It wouldn't be an ever-present problem. And I could imagine, of course, because we're talking about such a long time period, it would take 400 years. People are going to die from natural causes before he can kill everyone. He's going to kill about, I don't know, let's see, it's 443. Let's divide that by 70. How many people will he manage to kill before they die of some other reasons? He's going to be able to kill like 1/6 to 1/7 of the people that have seen his face before they die from some other reason. But of course, there's the possibility that while he's killing other people, you might end up seeing SCP-096. And early on, that's a real risk and possibility. And we bake that into the numbers a little bit. Say, early on, less than 6 billion people actually see him, but by the end of it, about that many people see him during his travels and or murders. But at the same time, society will shift. Just like how airplanes would probably end up carrying less people, you'd have, like, air raid sirens, and when the air raid siren goes off of the particular tone, or, you know, even your digital device gives you a warning that SCP-096 is in the area, you stay in your house, and if you hear a loud noise, you close your eyes if you haven't already seen him, you know? Like, you're just like, if you're one of those, and everyone would know, you know, like, I've seen SCP-096, I'm gonna go out and do my normal day-to-day stuff, who cares? If I see him again, what's the big deal? And if I haven't, oh, you haven't, you're under the age of such and such, you weren't alive when that happened, you're staying home, school's canceled today. Could you imagine the SCP-096 school cancelage? SCP-096 is in the area. Everyone stay home. Or no, it would just be a delay. That would be the funny part. They wouldn't cancel school that day. It would just be a 2-hour delay.
We got a heavy case of SCP-096 weather. So
it would be in the weather report. Oh my god, it would be in the weather report. That would be so funny. And this is where SCP-096 is today. He's over here. We don't have to really worry about it. If he starts moving in our direction, we will let you know.
Oh my god. Imagining that world is just, it's so much fun in my head. Anyway, that's my point.
There's all this, like, existential dread, right? Because if you, one person, sees SCP-096, you're gonna die very quickly. And this is, like, natural in your brain scaling up of that. So if I see SCP-096 and I die instantly, then if everyone sees SCP-096, the world is going to end. But no, as you scale up, it becomes impossible for this one monster to do anything truly impactful to the human population. Well, I shouldn't say that. This would be truly impactful to the human population, but it wouldn't be catastrophically bad. It would just be like adding an extra version of heart disease. Like, oh, well, a whole other version of death that's just as deadly as heart disease just popped up. And that's it. I'll tell you right now, that 2-second number that I gave you, that is a super low estimation for how long it would take for him to travel to and kill people. That number would be way higher. And even at 2 seconds, it's like 400 years, almost 450 years before it could kill everybody. I think it would be much worse, probably in the at least 1,000 years. Let's say 4 seconds or 8 seconds before it could kill everybody, you know? We're talking about, 2,000 years? Not gonna happen, man. It's just not gonna happen. Even with I love that. I was like, I originally was gonna go with 1 second, and I thought, that sounds way too fast. Even at 1 second, it would take him 200 years. The only difference is that it would be an extra one death per second in the world. I mean, you'd go from 1.8 to 2.8, and that's it. And yeah, it would be by far the largest cause of death, but it wouldn't even crack 50%. I think it'd be like 33% or something like that. Anyway, that's really it. Thank you for watching. Tell me how I'm wrong in the comments, or, you know, how you don't like being told you're wrong about something. If you like the content, though, scroll down and hit the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell next to that so you'll be notified when I upload a new video. And if you really want to support this content, head on over to patreon.com/dcimmerian. There's going to be a link in the description and at the end of the video, and pledge. Like everybody here on the screen already has. It's nice to know that I'm not alone out here. And I'll see you all again on Thursday. And you, Robert, I'm not joking. Hit the subscribe button, man. I really would appreciate it. And if you'd like, go on over to Patreon and pledge. Thanks.